Presented by ChurchTechU, it's the ProPresenter Show. On today's show, how to fake the old Telestrator module with an app called Video Pencil and an iPad. Hi, and welcome again to the ProPresenter Show. This is the show where I teach all about ProPresenter. My name is Paul Allen Clifford. And if you've ever wanted to be able to allow your pastor to mark up the ProPresenter screen and display that on the audience screen at exactly the same time, go ahead, like, subscribe, give me a thumbs up, write a comment, you know, all that stuff. So, I have actually talked to people that said that they were not going to upgrade from ProPresenter 6 until ProPresenter 7 had this feature. Now, it's not a lot of people, I admit that, but there are a few. So I thought that I would show you how to do it. I had an earlier version, but that required you to kind of export the slides, bring them into your device, and then use one app. Well, this app is a little bit better. It enables you to use the Apple Pencil, and it's just a great little feature here. There is some wiring involved, so this isn't totally wireless, but let's head over to the computer and we'll talk a little bit about that. So, first thing you're going to need to do is you need two screens. So if you're already using eight screens inside of ProPresenter, you're going to run into a problem with this. So that's thing number one. What we need is we need one screen that its job is to send the regular output of ProPresenter to the iPad. So we need one of those, and it should be an HDMI screen if possible. You can also do SDI and then convert that to HDMI at the iPad end. In fact, if it's a long cable run, that's absolutely what I would advise you to do. And then you will need a second screen, and this is the actual audience screen. So we're going to do like a fake audience screen and then a real audience screen, and you'll see what I'm talking about here in just a second. So the first thing that we're going to do is we're going to go to screens and then configure screens. And I've already done some of this work, but basically I've got a drawing preview here that I'm actually going to make that. So let me, while I'm at it, I'm going to delete an extra screen here that I don't need anymore. So I've got that. So this drawing preview screen is the one that I'm going to actually send out to the iPad. So right now I have this set as a placeholder. It actually needs to not be a placeholder. It needs to be an HDMI screen or an SDI screen that I convert to HDMI, because I'm going to capture it into the iPad. I will need a little bit of additional hardware to do this as well. So it just depends on if you've got the budget for all this, but everything is less than $100 total. So anyway, so I'm going to change this screen preview. Right now my audience is this left hand screen, and I'm going to do my screen preview on my right hand screen. So I'm going to go down here, and it's going to squawk at me because I think I'm already using that for a stage screen. So let's reassign to new. And so there we go. So I've got my audience screen is the left-hand screen, and the drawing screen is the right-hand screen here. So that's actually the one that we're looking at right now. So let me go ahead and let's put some stuff into into ProPresenter here. Do you like these videos, but you'd really like to learn from me in person? Well, I've got some great news for you. I am traveling around the country and maybe even around the world training churches on how to use ProPresenter. So I've got either a 1 or 1.5 day class that you can attend. For more details, head on over to tdm.fyi/events24, the top one right here, and register for the event nearest you. If there is no event that's near you, no problem, you can request one. So head on over to tdm.fyi/class request. That's this one down here, and you can say, hey, I'm interested in attending a class, or even I'm interested in hosting a class. Up to you which you prefer. In the last one, that is just information. It's not obligation, so don't hesitate to put your information in there, and I'll let you know when there's a class in your area, or we'll talk about what it takes to host a class. It's probably a lot less than you imagine that it is. So head over there, and I look forward to meeting you in person. So let's see here. Let's just bring up a Bible verse, shall we? So let's change this to King James, just because it's in the public domain. No other reason. So let's go with my non-serious life verse, Acts 26:24, because I always like a good joke. I'm going to put that up there. So now I have that on the screen. And so next thing I need to do is we need to take this full screen. Notice that both of these are off right now, so I'm going to, well, actually, before I do that, let me go into looks, and I've got a video pencil look, but we're just going to do this, and I'll show you what I have in mind. So for the drawing preview, I'm actually going to send the slide and media, etc., to it. And then for the audience, the what I'm actually sending to the audience, I'm going to disable everything except for the video input. So let me show you why I'm going to do that. So inside the Video Pencil app, there is an option to send the output over NDI. So if we go to ProPresenter and Settings or Preferences, depending on the OS you're on, and then Inputs, you'll notice that I have this Video Pencil in here. So to add it, I just click the plus button, and then under device, it shows up as localhost video pencil. That's just coming over the network here. So you can see it as it is right now. So I'm going to go ahead and delete this one because I already had one right here. And that's the one that I'm going to make sure is selected down here under video inputs. So video pencil. So that is good to go right there. The only problem is I need to do some rerouting to make sure that this is all correct. So first off, let me enable the screen here, and you'll see that there is a problem because I have some video routing issues. So let me see if we can't fix that here real quick. So real quick, one thing that I forgot to do was enable the video pencil look. So let me do that real quick. And so now this is showing in on my iPad, and now I should be able to except my Apple Pencil lost the connection. So real quick, let me reconnect it, and notice how I am drawing. So I'm going to circle beside right there, and thyself much learning doth make thee, and I'm gonna make a box around mad. So that's my funny life verse right there, and you can see how that I did that just in real time. So I'm gonna mark a little arrow down, 3, 2, 1, arrow down, and maybe another arrow to Paul, and you can see how your pastor can annotate stuff live using that app, and really get a lot of control. One other thing I can do is I can switch between colors. I can highlight. Okay, maybe that's not the highlighter. Maybe it's this guy. Yeah, that's the highlighter right there. And do it that way. So I've got a lot of flexibility. I can, with one button, clear the entire drawing. Or I could, let's say that I drew too much. I also have an eraser here, so I can erase that line and redraw it. And I just have a lot of flexibility. So basically, let me actually draw this out for you while we're while we are here. So I've got Pro 7 here, and I've got two outputs, bam and bam. So this output goes to the iPad with an HDMI capture device, which I'll leave linked with the description. HDMI. Okay, and then that sends the output over NDI back into ProPresenter. And then this output is the one that actually goes to the audience. And so referring back earlier to the look that I created, this one gets the slides, and this one only gets the NDI from my handwriting is atrocious, from Video Pencil. So that's how that's all working. Make sure that you've got everything routed correctly, because otherwise you'll get the feedback like I did initially when I was trying to show that to you. But that's basically how you go about and do that in ProPresenter 7. If you like this content, you'd probably like my ProPresenter 7 Quick Start course. So head on over to TDM. Oops, FYI/pro7 and quick. Give me your name and email address and I'll make a login for you for free. Until next time, this is Paul Allen Clifford from TrinityDigitalMedia.com and ChurchTechU.com, reminding you to go out and change eternity.